Hello Minecrafters, SONICzech here. Welcome to my another creative blog. Today I'm just keeping you guys updated of what I'm working on because, to be honest, I wasn't able to finish any speed build or a cinematic video because, first of all, I had a lot of stuff going on in college. I had a lot to do for my master's diploma measurements and so on and so on. And also I continue working on a lot of projects simultaneously, so neither of them are finished yet, and not yet to do a video about them, but I will show you all what I'm working on. And now I'm on a server with a custom map, and it's named Songs of Wars, and this is going to be the name of Minecraft animated series. And I've been invited to build here, so my builds are actually going to appear in these series. There are a lot of cool builds. They built a lot of cities, and I am supposed to build a Nether fortress, which is going to appear in a few episodes. So I'm going to make that looking cool and notable by the watchers. And this is pretty cool spawn. I don't know if it's gonna appear in the series, but now I'm going to show you all the other stuff I've been working on. So I haven't really started with the Nether Fortress here yet. That's what I have to do. I'm already a little behind. Now I'll just log off and log to the server in which I built that end style spawn. Here we go. So the staff on the server used my floating island forest hub. So that was the first thing that made me happy, that someone is actually using, well, I know a lot of people are using my builds, but it still pleases me a little that my builds are being used. And yeah, this is their hub. And now we'll warp ourselves to the server factions. And here we are. Now you can see what I made so far. It's a endstone island floating above the void. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is actually not a void, but it's a combination of black and purple glass with glowstone on the bottom layer. So I played with the combinations a lot so it will look like the void. There's also going to be the ceiling also looking like the void. And the owners have been quite specific with this build. They already knew, which doesn't happen a lot, they already knew what they want, how they want the spawn to look like. So one of the requests was that the spawn is going to be 250 times 250 blocks big. So this is a enormous sized spawn. That's what I want to say first of all. So it's the biggest spawn I ever worked on. Then they wanted the players to have a feeling like they spawned in the end, and as they walked far from the middle, closer to the edge, they want them to give the feeling that they're walking out of the end. So they will find themselves in a caving system, I would say. This is what I made here with a lot of stone pillars. That has some end fortress structures. Now it's not finished at all, maybe just the stone pillars, but I have to paste a lot more end fortress structure and make them a little more custom. There's some end fortress structures I copied from this server where the end portal is located. So that's what I'm going to do. Also, we haven't placed the obsidian pillars here. They are also going to be made a little more custom, not that boring as it is in game. And then as they pass through the end fortress cave, they will find themselves in a regular cave. And also there's going to be holes in the ceiling, so some light will shine through. And that's pretty it. So all what's left is the void ceiling, some obsidian pillar structures here, and fortress structures there, and it'll probably be done. All right, so that's that. You can expect some videos about this build. Now I'll connect to another server, and it's actually the faction spawn build. Oh yeah, I built the witch city there, and I also built the flying islands hub. And now we appeared right in the middle of my build, but actually this build is complete, but not really here. I just used this server for voxel sniper. Then I copied the schematic and pasted it and finished it in single player world. So this is probably just 20% of the whole build. Also, this is a flat world. I'll just set the weather clear. Flat world with a village generated. Well, as you can see, knock knock. So here we have a village flying above the void with a few survivors, a librarian, butcher, another librarian, and a priest. Well, whatever. This build isn't finished. I'm going to show you the build in single player world. But in this video and on this server, I have a major announcement for all of you guys, and that is that, wait a second, dramatic pause. Here we go. This is the Flying Islands hub. There it is. And this whole hub is going to be able for public download and placement and editing whatever you want to do with it from now on today. That's the announcement. That's the announcement. And I'll also edit the whole build, and I have also a world copy in my single player world. I'll also edit it so it will serve, it will be able to serve as a, well, look at that, spilling water. Someone was probably playing around here. Well, never mind, that's on this server. It's not in the world you're gonna download. And I'm also going to edit the whole build to serve as a skyblock. No, not a skyblock, a Skywars map as well. So there are going to be little islands in the circle around, the bigger islands in the middle. So that's this build. And now, as I promised you, the ice PvP arena. Now why am I clicking on multiplayer? Single player, and I don't know, maybe it's this? No, it's the Flying Islands hub. It's in the same map. I just pasted it here. So this is it. Okay, I'm going to show you from outside and going lower. So this is the outside. It's a huge box made by me with a nice snowflake I made here. It's a shame that no one's gonna see it from inside, because this is where the players are gonna spawn, where they'll select their kits probably. There's enough room for signs and all the kits, and then they choose from 5 holes where to drop into the arena. So this is the center hole, and there are 4 holes on the sides. So let's say I'll drop here. The players should also manage to drop into the water. Otherwise they'll take fall damage. Maybe you can turn off the fall damage from here with some plugin. I don't know, I'm not really experienced with that. But yeah, they're supposed to drop in water, jump out, and from this hole they'll find themselves on a cliff. So they'll have a vantage point, higher ground. This is the main drop in the middle. And you can see that there are caves below the ice. I also made it visible from here. And they are just for the looks, just to add a little more depth to the build. But the players are not actually able to go down there. So it's made of the main level, mostly snow. And then they have a few ways to climb on these cliffs, get here. So it's all ice and snow themed PvP, kit PvP arena. So yeah, that's that. You can guys expect the speed builds. Probably this video will be the released soonest of all builds, and I cannot really promise when it's gonna be up, because I still have a lot of the stuff going on in college and a lot of projects going on. I have to build on that Songs of War server, because I just promised them I'll make them an epic nether fortress. And so on and so on. I could continue like an hour of all the stuff I have to do. So yeah, thanks for watching from the start to the end. Thank you guys for being with me the whole time. I am already almost hitting 1k of subscriber count, which is an enormous number. I didn't expect that. Looks like a lot of players are interested in my builds, more than I even can build in one lifetime. So I am really proud that players like my builds. I'm glad that you guys are all with me. And I'll keep you guys updated and fed up with more building videos. So thank you guys for watching. This was SONICzech. Thanks for watching.